Hey guys, this is Tim from Tim's Electronics Lab and welcome back to another video. Firstly, I'd like to apologize for not uploading. My computer is broken, as simple as that. And all my files are on my computer. Now I am able to access all my data, fortunately enough. But my processor and motherboard is dead, or are dead, or are going to die. Sometimes it boots up and then all of a sudden it just powers down, like there's a very hard crash, a hardware crash. You know, no fan spins, nothing. So yeah, it's time for me to upgrade to another processor and motherboard. And by the time you're watching this video, that probably has happened, because then I've got a new computer so that I can edit this video on. But today, this video is about the motor that I received today for the windmill project. So let's open it right away, because I'm very curious at what's inside. Now, it shows caution lithium ion batteries, but I don't think there's a lithium ion battery inside a servo, so let's check. Nice package. It's a rather big one, and that's good. It's a 140 kV motor. It feels very nice. Ooh, the axis is too big. I can see that right away. The axis is way too big. So we need to create an adapter for that. But it does feel really good. Now, they supplied the motor with a MT30 connector, and I bought a connector set to connect a cable to that connector. So let me just grab a cable or a connector and let's solder some cables to the connector so we can take a look at the voltages being generated by the motor spinning. My soldering iron, of course, has heated up to 480 degrees, because otherwise it wasn't possible. I can also stick it inside here. Oh, wrong connector. Now I'm in luck that there are a few of the other connectors inside here. Otherwise I would have needed to order, oh no, I picked the wrong connector by accident. There are a few male connectors in the female connection package, and I accidentally picked a male connection, and I needed a female. So Is it going to hold? Yes, I think it is. Nice, strong connection there. Of course, other heat shrink. There goes the camera. That's one cable. Now soldering to the connectors is really easy. I heated up my soldering iron to 480, so it should be easy, but it's surprisingly easy. Now, of course, I'm still going to add one huge heat shrink over all the connectors. Just for strain relief. On the other hand, I quite like the loose wire sticking out, so maybe I'll just leave it like this. Black one. Nice. So they're soldered up now. Let me do the ends of the connector. Alright, so, all soldered up. Let's grab the conversion board, and that is right here. And let's connect the connector to it. Don't know what order, but I guess that this is a good order. Black, green, and orange. Alright, so let's connect it. The connector fits. Let's try to see what happens when I rotate it manually. Of course, try to keep it in shot. Oh, I can already see the light lighting up. Don't know. I think you can see that. Well, let me zoom in for you. Look, the LED is lighting up. Now, if I take the drill, other side. This is at 1700 RPMs. But the thing isn't properly centered. And now it is, I think. No, it's even worse. Yeah, this is better. Let's check the oscilloscope at the measurements. So the scope, I think you're not in focus. Focus. You are probably in focus. So. Now let's bring the bottom one a little bit up, like that. You can see that they're all nicely in phase, if I are out of phase, as they should. Now it's volts peak to peak. And a maximum of 5 volts. Now let's check the output of the rectifier. With the fourth channel. Alright, fourth channel, bring it up a little, 3 volts should be enough, 3, and let's try it again, out of the view, I want the measure of channel 4. Wow, I want to see the current value, can I? Thanks for watching this video. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you did, please leave a like. Make sure to leave a comment down below. You can also share this video with your friends if you think they will like it too. See you next time.